Superlist 1.0 is out today. The official successor to Wunderlist is on the market, and we're going to give you a full rundown of everything you need to know about this brand new to-do list experience. Whether it's right for you, whether it is going to be the to-do experience that you use for your team, and whether it can even take notes for you, do little AI activities, and much more. If you're new here, do subscribe. It'd be great to have you. And also, we've got a brand new email newsletter, which I'll link below, called Tool Digest, to discover new tools and lots more. Now, Superlist have also passed over a discount code. If you did like it, then you can find the discount code below for 20% off subscriptions. But let's roll into this video. I've been quite excited to show you this one because I've played around with it in beta for some time, and I think this is one of the apps that automatically goes into the one of the top 10s because in my list I create for Toolfinder, because what it's done is it made a really smooth application. It's made a beautiful one, and one that fits some interesting needs on the market, and that's why it automatically goes into that list. And I'm going to show you why I think today. So what is Superlist? Very simply, it's a to-do list app that can be used as an individual or for teams, and it has not just task abilities, but it also has abilities to make notes. So it's sort of like your project management a little bit in a sense, and I'll show you what that means in a moment. So here we are. I'm going to show you some of the things I really liked about the experience so far. So very notably, the design is really, really nice. You can see from instantaneously, there's just a real relaxed nature to it. The animations are really smooth as well, like moving between them and even clicking off. Everything just falls into place, which is really nice. You can go into lots of different areas. Inbox is your first one, really. And this right here is a task. So what I can do here is I can change the due date to tomorrow. And you can see that I've got some subtasks here. I can assign them to people, myself, for example, and I can even give them due dates and labels as well. And down here, I can leave comments as well as even leaving a voicemail too, which is quite nice as well. So if I want to just leave a little snippet, that's quite handy. I've not seen that as of yet, which is quite cool. So if I go up here, I can just copy the link. I can complete it from up here too, which gives it a hierarchical thing. And there's some quite nice sound animations when you do click things on. Now up in the top right-hand corner, you can do filtering, which is pretty standard across most to-do list applications. And you can have a today area for anything that is coming up today. And you can also see overdue, which that one was. Now, what's different about these different these subtasks area is you can knock out the subtask and actually start typing away. And here you can start using and adding tasks. You can have headings, for example, like talk about the list function. And I can go down here and I can add images, I can add attachments, I can add bullet points. Maybe even talk about the list and so on and so forth. But what's really interesting is I can even add a divider, and the dividers look even more interactive. This, I'm sort of jumping ahead of myself here, but you can move stuff around like it was inside of a document, and anywhere where I want to drag anything, it can be dragged, which is pretty cool. Now, in terms of how this is actually usable, is if I go to site lists, this is a list that I've created. Actually, maybe even better to just create a new list. So let's say we're planning a project like Project A, and I've invited a couple of people to this, which I could do up here. Some of the sharing abilities I'll go through in a moment. But if I wanted to, I could start this project by saying, we're launching Project A. And I could start writing bullet points here as well, or I could start writing tasks if I want to as well. And those tasks then have real life assignments. So Project A plan, and I could assign that to myself and give it a due date next week. So you can start to see that these interactive elements are useful for being able to start breaking down the task. I could even make potential meeting notes here and start tallying them down. I could add images if I wanted to as well. For example, maybe this one, just as an image to demonstrate. And it could even add attachments as well for other people to find in this document as well. So if I, I'm just spamming it with all the other productivity apps. And you can move these elements about as well. So why is this really powerful? Because teams can go in here and they can begin collaborating on a tasks with their notes in mind. And for some people, that's really great because they can store meeting notes, they can plan and assign stuff to other people. And everyone who's working in these collaborative spaces are actually real time, which means that you can see others interact with each other. Now, in terms of the abilities with Teams, it's quite cool because they've added the ability to hide like lists that are part of your personal and hide lists that are part of Teams. So if I go into my team account, I can go to browse all and I can start seeing all of the lists that are part of my team. Actually, don't think I've got any team lists, so maybe I can go and create one. So here we go, toolfinder reviews, and I can naturally see that this is shared with anyone who's in that team workspace. And that's very in particularly interesting because I can go in there and I can actually say personal to-do list and switch between them. And that gives a little bit of separation to the work, which I think a lot of people will like. Now, as you can imagine, there are some more abilities in this. Messages being one of them, which mean that you can get any, it's like a secondary inbox for any items that come up. There's also a really extensive settings page, which I really, really liked. And you can actually connect up integrations. And you can see here, for example, you can convert any emails from your Superlist from your emails that are in Gmail. And you can set that up by starring them, which is really helpful. You can automatically send them to your Google Calendar so it populates the space that you're doing them in. Same with Microsoft To Do if you want to sync them two ways, which is quite nice. I've set up email forwarding, so I'm just going to demonstrate this live as well. So if I go ahead and send myself a task. Okay, so here I sent this one through email, and what it's automatically done is summarize that email as well, which is really nice. And it does that through the integrations because I've got task summarization attached, which is a premium feature, which turns emails into actionable tasks and summarizes them. You can also get that in Slack as well, I believe, or you can create Superlist tasks from Slack, GitHub, Linear, and Figma, which is really nice. Now, this is a really good integration to have from day one because not many apps have this sort of thing from day one. So it's nice to have the consolidation type experience in there. Whilst maybe it's not as extensive as some other ones, it's actually pretty decent. So in terms of things that I didn't necessarily like about Superlist, one of the things that I did state beforehand was regarding the fact that you, for example, every time you have a new task, you have to assign it to yourself. Although that's not necessarily true, it's just that little icon that indicates yourself only pops up and sort of looks a little bit strange without that being there. So that was just one thing I noticed. And the other elements were not very detailed. Aside from that, I didn't really have any major issues with this application. So I was actually pretty impressed with the free experience and some of the paid pricing options. So that's a good segue to get into pricing. So here is the pricing. And I like to go by monthly because a lot of people like that option to know if they want to trial something, what's it going to be like? As I said, the free plan, you get unlimited task notes and reminders and unlimited private lists, 5 shared lists for up to 5 people, Google Workspace, Google Calendar, Gmail, and Microsoft To Do, and email forwarding, as well as email task summarization and up to 10 megabytes and 500 file uploads. To be honest, that's a damn good free plan pricing. Really good. Because there's no real limits here apart from the 5 shared lists with up to 5 people. And to be honest, that's after 5 people, that's when it's going to get serious. There's a pro plan which gives you access to the Slack, Figma, and Linear and GitHub integrations and unlimited share lists for up to 25 people with AI list creation coming soon and some more storage limits. That's 10 per month. There's also a free team plan, which I've got, which is up to 5 members. And there doesn't seem to be any limits, which is pretty good. After that, it's $12 per month, which is probably the price of a typical, maybe the same price as a project management software on the lowest rung of their pricing. So to be honest, that's something to note. But they have stated here that everyone in the team pro plan will get pro as part of their personal plan, which is pretty good. That's a nice little bonus. And soon they'll have unlimited shared lists with teams and guests, which is pretty good. So to be honest, as a pricing plan, I'm pretty impressed at that, because that free tier is very good. Like, there's no worries there, especially when you're wanting to create some notes as well. And for some people who do want to have that note taking, you could, for example, have here like films I want to see, and you can go and customize it here. So if I typed in movie, if I can spell, but you can start tallying the films you want to see. Like, I want to see the Planet of the Apes film, the new one. And you get the idea. So you could keep it really, really simple. You could even, you know, break them up into like lists, like that are list based and work, although obviously that's where the team account comes in. But you get the idea. You can start to begin to organize them a little bit more structurally. But that's where the notes can actually be helpful. Like, I'm not saying it's going to replace an entire note taking system like Notion or Evernote, etc. Just some final things. You can also change the emoji here, but you can also, I believe it's in the free plan, you can add a picture for your own. So for example, if I wanted a nice picture of the family, then I could, but I'm going to upload this meme of the calendar apps in the market right now and have the meme format there. So that's a nice little addition there. And it's the way they've built this application is really, really nice. There's some really nice, like if you press C quite fast, you can add a task. It's a very good to-do list application. Other things that I haven't mentioned yet, they actually got 13.5 million euros in funding by Cherry Ventures and EQT for this. So that's a good sort of bit of legway or runway for them. The AI-assisted elements will improve over time, and they're the team behind Wunderlist aims to help millions of people and teams organize and collaborate. They say as well that research indicates that over 75% prefer not to use company tools for personal organization due to the privacy concerns, which Superlist addresses with its design and privacy settings. So to be honest, like, this is a really nice experience for solo users to be able to use in terms of managing their tasks. But then if their team wants to upgrade, then you can pretty easily do that and not disrupt your experience. So this is going to be available on Mac, iOS, Android, and web. And I have no issues that this is not going to be fluid. Like, I've played with it. It's very clean and easy to use. So that's a very good experience. As I said, it's going into one of our best to-do list applications already. So that's really notable. But aside from that, a very interesting experience overall. I will be continuing to follow Superlist and see what they're doing. So remember to check out the links in the description. If you do like it, you can upgrade and use a discount code. But otherwise, I hope this review gave you everything you need to know. And I look forward to seeing you in a future video. Do subscribe, and we'll catch you all very soon. Cheerio!